Welcome to Sew Anastasia, and today I'm going to go over this amazing hot pink sewing machine. Obviously, I love hot pink. It is the Viking 980Q Epic. What I love about this machine is that it only does sewing techniques. Whether you're a quilter or a garment sewer, it has every single technique built into this machine to give you an amazing sewing experience. Okay, let's turn this baby on. There's a little button on the side, and then your screen is going to take a minute to turn on. Ah, the joys of sewing. One of the most wonderful things about this machine is that it has a giant touchpad advisory screen. So you can choose from sewing, quilting, and it also has a knowledge center. What? So cool. So no more flipping through pages of books looking for things, because if you have a question, you just search it right here. You hit the little magnifying glass, so that's gonna pop up, and you can type in whatever. So earlier I was looking for sequin stitches, so you can type it in. And then hit okay. And then it's gonna pop up down here. And so I can click on that, and it's gonna tell me about the sequin stitches, and then there's some videos you can watch inside of it. What? You guys wanna check out the video? So you hit play, and it's going to demonstrate for you how to do the technique. So it not only goes over stitches, but it also goes over collars, waistbands, how to set in a sleeve, all within the machine. How crazy. But doesn't talk to you, so you're still gonna have to watch my YouTube videos. So we're gonna select some techniques. I'm gonna show you what is in the machine that you can choose from right now. So we have basic sewing techniques, we have collars, hems and edge finishes, necklines, pockets, ruffles and gathering, my favorite, tux pleats and darts, waistlines, zippers, four different types of zippers, dimensional stitches, which I'm really excited about, and then we're back to basic sewing techniques. So all of these techniques are in your machine, and it's going to show you how to properly execute them. So cool. Another really amazing feature on the machine is that you can select your fabric, and it's automatically going to adjust your tensions, recommend what needle you should be using, and advise you for that type of fabric. Something really cool is that it has vinyl on here, leather, it has your wovens and your stretches, light, medium, and heavy. So that basically covers everything. Pretty cool. It also has a ton of amazing features over in the quilting section. So let's click on quilting at the very top, and you can go through the techniques here. So we have bindings, applique, quilting, and it'll go down here, stitch in the ditch, stitch straight quilting, free motion quilting. There's more options at the bottom. It has piecing. We're back to binding. I'm gonna click on one of the tabs so I can show you it's virtually in all of them when you click on them. So I've hit applique. I'm gonna click on applique. My sewing advisor screen's gonna pop up, but at the very bottom, it's gonna talk about applique. And then you can keep going, and it's gonna list your materials you need to applique. And then it's also going to give you some videos. So this one's giving you a video on drying the applique. So let's hit play. And then up here on the screen, it's gonna demonstrate what you should be doing to create an applique. The really cool thing about the machine is that no matter what tab you're clicking on, it's going to go over all of the details on how to create the technique. So like me, I'm not a big quilter, but I would love to quilt, and so this is going to offer me some insight into things I don't know about quilting. It's gonna give me lists of materials, it's gonna give me desired stitches, and it's going to give me videos on this one, how to applique, or how to do binding, which is great. So maybe I'm gonna get into quilting. Now we're going to move over to the Knowledge Center. So it's the tab on the far right. So in here we have our stabilizer guide, then we also have our quick start guide. So if you click on stabilizer, it's going to recommend different types of stabilizers, the characteristics of the stabilizers, and when you should be using them properly. So you can go ahead and click tearaway, specialty, or batting. We also have a user guide, and that's going to be at the very top in the brown tab up on top. And this is going to eliminate a user guide that's probably like 400 pages thick. So you can go ahead, read through this, or if you're looking for something very specific, again, just hit on the search, the little magnifying glass, and you can type in whatever it is you're looking for and it'll find it for you. So cool. This machine also has a few other really cool features that I would like to point out. It has a setup for two spools of thread. You don't always have to sew with a double needle of two threads, obviously, but it has the option to. And this large disc here you put down, and it's for the large cones of thread. Brilliant, love this. I think I'm gonna put this accessory on all of my other Viking sewing machines as well if it fits. So you'll notice that your thread comes all the way up here and then it comes down through the machine. So I love this feature on it. It kind of reminds me almost of an industrial sewing machine. Another really cool feature on this machine is that it has an automatic needle threader like none you've ever seen before. You literally take the thread and slip it in between two discs, and you hit a button and it threads it for you. That's it. Brilliant. I love it. Another thing I really love about this machine is that the top of the bobbin case, yes, it's clear, which is great, but you can't just pull it off towards you, which sometimes I feel like machines, while you're sewing, it'll slip off, so you literally have to pull back a little button and then the top of your bobbin case will pop off. Love it. I don't know about you, but one of my least favorite parts about sewing is running out of the bobbin and having to unthread the machine to wind a bobbin. Not anymore. You can leave your machine threaded and wind a bobbin at the same time. And on this machine, you're going to wind the bobbin on the side of the machine over here while you leave it threaded. So cool. When they designed this machine, they definitely took into consideration design and aesthetics because it is large enough to fit your sewing projects under it. It's bright enough to see your tone-on-tone fabrics and threads. It has two spots for threads, and it's pink. Who doesn't love pink? Well, you might not love pink, but I love pink. So they were definitely thinking about me when they made this machine. And the side of it lights up and it's hot pink. It's kind of like a disco. There's also a light in here by your thread as well. This machine is literally lit up. Thanks so much for watching today. I hope you enjoyed everything about the Epic 980Q. I have highlighted just a handful of my favorite features of this machine because, well, it's amazing and it's pink and it sews virtually everything and anything. So stay tuned for some new in-depth videos on the machine as well. Thanks so much for watching Sew Anastasia today. Make sure you follow me on Instagram at Sew Anastasia. And if you want to see more about my design life in the boutique, Anastasia Chatzka. Also check out sewanastasia.com and anastasiachatzka.com for everything sewing and fashion related. And if you love all the videos I'm putting out, support me on Patreon. There's a link below in the description. If you have any questions or comments, just leave them in the comments section below the video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.